Hello again, Magnus Holberg here. Tonight we're going to talk a little bit about yard tests. Why they're good, how they're done. Yard tests, a simple way of optimizing sedimentation. With yard tests, you can do the testing at site, so no need for transport of water, which could change the quality of the water maybe. Also, you will be doing the test at the correct temperature, correct water temperature. Also, with yard tests, I have worked with 1 liter vessels. In one test, you can run in parallel up to maybe 5 or 6 yard tests. And probably a test run you maybe 1 hour. So 1 hour you can get 6 answers back. So it's very effective. Also, importantly, a parameter you always need to be careful with. What is the optimum pH for my flocculation? For instance, you have 6 yards, you can test 6 different pH at the same time. Also, you can estimate the mixing time for the flocculant. You can also get a notion of the flocculation time. 10 minutes or 5 minutes for the flocculation times, you need to double the volume of the flocculation vessel. You can test combination of flocculants, metal flocculants, polymers. You also get a very good idea of how much chemicals will be consumed. Also, estimation of surface loads, which is what you need to design the sedimentation. There are things you need to consider, but within this small 1 liter yard test, you can get a pretty good idea of the surface load. Also, you can get a good idea of sludge generation with the yard tests. So let's have a look at some of the results. You always use is turbidity because that's directly correlated to particles or suspended solids. You try to find an optimum dose with the lowest turbidity. In this case, I did a test where I looked at polymer, and also I did the test without any metal coagulant. So it was just polymer that was dosing. On the y-axis, you had the turbidity after sedimentation. On the x-axis, you had the dosing of polymer. And to get the lowest turbidity, the dose here was 400 microliters. But it could also be that 400 microliters is maybe too much of chemicals. So maybe if you look at 200, is the turbidity acceptable? Then you might be able to go down in dose to 200. Now, looking at the speed of sedimentation, or i.e. that is the surface load, meter per hour, you can also get this from the yard test. You have the height of the beaker, and when you start the sedimentation time, you just clock how long it takes for the flocs to fall down to the bottom of the beaker. Then you get a indication of the surface load for this type of water with this type of suspended solids. Now, I will go to the last slide, and for you who've seen these videos before, you know there will be some pictures from Gotland. So, here are 2 pictures from Gotland. I won't tell you what they are, but they are from a museum, which I talked about before. With that, I hope you like the pictures, and I will say thank you. Remember, water really rocks. Take good care, and bye-bye.